We're given the rational function f of x and asked to determine the following function values, f of 1, f of negative 6, and f of 1/8. We'll first do this by hand, then check the function values on the graphing calculator, and then also take a look at the graph of f of x. So to determine the function value f of 1, we'll substitute 1 for x, which would give us 1 divided by the quantity 1 plus 2 minus 2. Let's first simplify this fraction. We'd have 1/3 minus 2, which I'll write as minus 2 over 1, because to perform this subtraction, we do have to obtain a common denominator, which would be 3. So we're going to multiply 2 over 1 by 3 over 3 to find an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 3. So now we have 1/3 minus 6/3. Denominator stays 3, and the numerator would be 1 minus 6, which is negative 5. So we say f of 1 equals negative 5/3. Graphically, this means our function f of x would contain the point with an x-coordinate of 1 and a y-coordinate of negative 5/3, which we'll verify at the end of this video. To find f of negative 6, we substitute negative 6 for x, which would give us negative 6 divided by the quantity negative 6 plus 2, and then minus 2. Again, we'll simplify this fraction first. We have negative 6 over negative 4 minus 2, but negative 6/4 does simplify. A negative divided by a negative is positive, and 6/4 simplifies to 3/2. So this would be 3/2 minus 2, or 2 over 1. Again, we have to obtain a common denominator, which would be 2. So now we'll multiply 2 over 1 by 2 over 2. Notice now our denominator is 2. The numerator would be 3 minus, this would be 4. 3 minus 4 is negative 1. So our function value is negative 1/2. So we can say f of negative 6 equals negative 1/2. Or if we were to graph the function would contain the point with an x-coordinate of negative 6 and the y-coordinate of negative 1/2. Now this last one's a little bit more challenging because when we substitute a fraction into our rational function, we'll have a complex fraction or fractions within fractions. But the process is the same. We're going to substitute 1/8 for x. So we would have 1/8 divided by the quantity 1/8 plus 2. I'm going to write 1/8 plus 2 over 1, and then minus 2. So let's first add these fractions here in the denominator. Notice the common denominator would be 8, so we'll multiply 2 over 1 by 8 over 8. So now we'd have 1/8 divided by, this would be 1/8 plus 16/8, which would be 17/8. And then still minus 2. Remember, this fraction bar here just means division. So we can write this as 1/8 divided by 17/8, which is equivalent to multiplying by the reciprocal of 17/8. So we can write this as 1/8. Again, instead of dividing by this fraction here, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal, which would be 8/17, and then minus 2. Now we'll find this product. Notice how we have 8 over 8 that simplifies to 1. So now we have, this would be 1/17 minus 2 over 1. Obtaining our common denominator of 17, we'll multiply by 17 over 17. So now we have a common denominator of 17. And the numerator would be 1 minus 2 times 17 is 34. 1 minus 34 is negative 33. So our function value is negative 33/7, or we can say that f of 1/8 equals negative 33/17. which again means if we were to graph this function, the function would contain the point with an x-coordinate of 1/8 and a y-coordinate of -33/17. Now let's go ahead and verify all three of these function values using the graphing calculator. There are a couple ways of doing this. But we're going to go ahead and type in our function f of x in y1. So I'm going to press y equals, clear out any old functions, and type in the new function, which is x divided by the quantity x plus 2. So x plus 2 must be in parentheses. Without the parentheses, only the x here would be in the denominator, and then minus 2. And now we're going to go back to the home screen by pressing second mode. And now we'll find these function values by using function notation, but we'll use y1 instead of f. So we'll press vars, right arrow once, enter. This brings y1 to the home screen, and now in parentheses, we'll enter 1. So open parenthesis, 1, close parenthesis, and now we just press enter. Now this is a rounded function value. We want the exact function value, so we'll convert this to a fraction by pressing math, and then enter. This verifies that f of 1 equals -5/3. Now we want to determine f of -6, so again we're going to press vars, right arrow, enter, and then in parentheses, we're going to type in -6, enter, and we should recognize this as -1/2, but to convert to a fraction, we'll press math, enter. Verifying our function value, f of -6 is -1/2. And now for the last function value of f of 1/8, we're going to press vars, right arrow, enter one more time, and now in parentheses, we'll enter 1/8. Enter. Again, we don't want to use this value, we want the exact value, so we'll convert this to a fraction. So we'll press math, enter, which once again verifies our function value is correct. Now it is important to remember that when we find a function value, we're actually finding a point on the graph of the function. So to verify this, let's take a look at the graph of the function. Here are the three points on the function that we found by determining the three function values. Again, f of 1 equals -5/3, which means the function contains the point with an x-coordinate of 1 and a y-coordinate of -5/3 here. F of -6 equals -1/2 represents the point with an x-coordinate of -6 and a y-coordinate of -1/2 here. And then finally, the last function value, f of 1/8 equals -33/17, represents the point with an x-coordinate of 1/8 and a y-coordinate of -33/17 by this point here. Notice how all these points are on the graph of the given function. I hope you found this explanation helpful.